With me now on Zoom is Jim Hotelling from Hillside Garden Landscaping. And Jim, today we're going to talk about some more of Hillside's recommendations for plants for a low maintenance garden. So Jim, what do you have for us today?
Well, actually, I'm going to talk about two different types of grasses, ornamental grasses. And when people think about ornamental grasses, they think about these really tall, you know, plants they see. But there are some very low ones that are quite nice. And the first one is called Carex. And there's several varieties, a lot of varieties actually, and they're low. And the Carex varieties will tolerate a fair amount of sun, but there's a lot of them that will actually grow in the woods. And there's a lot of native varieties of Carex. So there's a number of ornamental selections that have some good colors and what have you. And nice plants and tough.
Gotcha. So what makes these so special to you then?
Well, they're tough plants. They're deer resistant, which is a really big plus around here. Shade tolerant, again, that shady area. And they can be pretty much left alone and not a lot of fuss with them. So they're really tough, low maintenance plants. Now, this particular one in this picture is one called Bowles Golden. And this one was put, next to this tree over 20 years ago. And since that first year, it has not been watered. It hasn't been cut off. It has had no care whatsoever. And then here's a picture of it. If it's growing in good conditions, what it can look like.
Okay. And so how do you use these in a garden? How do you recommend our viewers use these?
Well, they basically can be put as single plants, you know, mixed in the garden as specimens just to accent and give a little different texture. Or you can actually use them in mass where you have quite a few different plants all together and just let them grow together as a ground cover. The second plant I want to talk about is a grass called Hakonechloa. Kind of a funny name, but it is tough, low growing, all the same attributes as the Carex, but it has a more of a flowing, arching look. And it's an interesting plant. We've used it a lot, good color. It is not invasive at all. And it'll spread fairly quickly into a nice large clump.
Okay. I don't even want to attempt to say this name, but are they deer resistant?
Yes, they're deer resistant. Again, not invasive, deer resistant, shade tolerant, all of the above.
Gotcha. And what kind of tips do you have on planting these grasses?
Well, the fact that they can tolerate shade, which you got to be careful of, you know, shade amounts to a lot of times trees and tree roots. And, you know, you bring them in those situations, you get a lot of competition with shade, water, roots, and all. So planting a decent sized hole with some good soil rounding and watering them really well that first season till they get established.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jim, for joining us today.
I'm Jim Hotelling.